150 kilometres south of the extreme desert heat, there's still no escaping high temperatures for Rick Fishers.
Oh, this is rough country. It can get really dangerous when it gets hot out here this time of year. And where I'm about to go, I need to have my wits about me.
Rick's heading to a quartz reef on the edge of the desert that he's heard could contain ounces of gold.
Holy moly. Now that's a reef. Check out the size of that.
A quartz reef evolves over millions of years when the hot, salty solution in which the golden quartz were dissolved vaporizes during a violent earthquake. The rocks are now slowly eroding, hopefully exposing gold embedded in quartz.
Wow, look at the size of this quartz blow. It's huge.
To finally come across this, I've heard a little bit about it, but to see it with my own eyes, it's absolutely amazing. But if there's quartz like this lying around the place, there's bound to be some gold out there. There has to be.
I've got a few hours of daylight left. I'm going to go out and have a bit of a sweep over the ground just to see if I can find something.
Rick has permission to detect here from an old friend who owns the remote lease.
Hey, that's a target. Right there. All right. Let's hope it's gold. Well, it's still in the ground, and that's always a good sign. All right, we might be onto something here. Let's do it. Yeah, okay, she's out of the hole now. Here we go. Oh yeah, she's in here. Ah, it's in my hand. Oh, holy cow! Wow, that is so big. That's huge. This is great. This shows me that there's good gold here. It's a decent size. I'd be guessing probably 8-9 grams.
The $450 nugget could be confirmation that Rick's long journey wasn't in vain.
And even better, it doesn't look like too many people have been through here with a metal detector. You know what? It's getting late in the day. I don't think this gold's going anywhere. Be back here first thing tomorrow. All right.
It's amazing what a good night's sleep, good wash, shower, and being on the gold can do. I might even get target today.
But Rick's confidence will have to overcome high local temperatures, forecast to climb to 48 degrees Celsius.
Here we go. I've got a horrible feeling today's going to be a stinker. Ah, here we go, there's a target. Give away some of this. Yeah, it's still there. That's a great sign. Have a listen. Oh yeah, that's out. Come on. Here we go. Yeah. Ah, there it is. You little ripper. Nice little nugget. Oh, that's a keeper, that one.
This 1 gram nugget is worth about $50.
Straight away, it's 8 o'clock in the morning. Starting to heat up a bit, but I'm on the gold. All right. Yeah. Oh, hang on. Not quite finished yet. Oh, this is good. This is good. There's still some other target under the ground here, and I'm betting it's another gold nugget. Here it comes. Come on. Ah, there it is. Look at that. Another little one. Beautiful little nugget. Two in the one hole.
That's another $50 nugget onto his tally.
Hard work, but geez, I tell you what, it's getting hot.
This time of year, the sun rises at 4:25 in the morning. It's an insane time for the sun to come up. And by 8 o'clock in the morning, you're well into the 30s. I'm finding myself drinking so much this morning. It's just so hot. I'm going through litres and litres and litres.
At these high temperatures, Rick could be losing up to 3 litres of fluid per hour.
In this heat, it's really easy to get dehydrated. You can suddenly find yourself being a little bit delusional, a little bit lost.
Oh, hang on. There we go. Yeah, that sounds really interesting. Okay, she's out. Yeah, that's a loud target, that one. Oh, here we go. Oh, there it is, sitting in my hand. Nice. If I keep going like this, I'm going to be out of here in no time. I'm going to make season target.
This 5-gram nugget is worth $250. Rick's now just 2.5 ounces short of his target.
This is so much gold here. It was a massive effort to get out here in the middle of nowhere, but this gamble's paying off. It's starting to get really hot now. Feels like it's going up by a degree every half hour. I'm on the gold, but it feels like it's just a race against the clock now.
The temperature's now hit 40, and it's still only mid-morning.
I'm going through a bit of this stuff.
Rick's water bag only contains 1.5 litres. He needs double that to avoid dehydration.
I'm smashing through this water. I've got to keep it up, keep the fluids up. It's starting to get really hot. And I'm starting to question myself whether or not this is really the right thing to do. Is this the right place for me to be? Am I really willing to risk my life for a few nuggets?
I've just got to make sure I look after myself, number one, keep hydrated, and hopefully I'll be okay.